sheriff's on my trail. And if he catches up with me, I'll spend my life in jail. I got a wife in Chino Bay and one in Cherokee. First one said she got my time, but it don't look like me. Said I don't really wanna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home for daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight.
Be warm and human and grateful, and have a good thing to say. thoughtful and trustful and childlike. Let them hear you outside. Be thoughtful and trustful and childlike. Be witty and happy and wise. Be honest and love all your neighbors. Be honest and love all your neighbors. Be obsequious, purple, and clairvoyant.
Be obsequious, purple, and clairvoyant.
All right, last verse. Let's really bring the house down now. You ready?
Be pompous, obtuse, and eat cactus.
Be dull and boring and omnipresent.
Be dull and boring and omnipresent.
Put a live chicken in your underwear.
Put a live chicken in your underwear.
Go into a closet and suck eggs.
Go into a closet and suck eggs.
Invite my co-host out. He hasn't been back since last year, and we keep up with each other on the phone sometimes, and he's one of my favorite people in the world. Y'all please welcome Steve Poltz.
Nice to see you, Shauna. It's great. I love you. Oh man, that was so good. How are you guys all doing? Kind of excited because my dad's here. Where is he? Hey Dad. I never get to say that normally. Hey Dad, where are you? Will you stand up so I can see you? Hey, there he is. Hi, Dad. And my sister, Kat. I thought we were going to lose them both. And they both survived. And I decided I would bring them out here. Now, I've been hearing... Have you guys ever looked on this thing called Facebook? A lot of times people argue. And so there's a lot of bad news. And I figured... When I woke up this morning, I wanted to write a song about being more optimistic. Couldn't we use a little optimism in this world? So I scribbled down these lyrics. I say scribbled, I typed them into my phone. Yeah, so I would like to debut this. If you don't mind holding them, that would be great. Yeah, this is great. I kind of wrote it as I was just waking up. Here we go. No, it's not too long, no. There was an optimist in the corner. Even he was looking bad. Said I was off to be kissed. Now I'm lost in the mist. I'm feeling kind of sad. He said sometimes things go sideways and it makes me want to yell. I want to climb to the top of that mountain. I'm going to ring that optimist bell. Ring, ring, ring. I'm going to ring, ring, ring. I'm going to ring that optimist bell. Here's to hoping that your ears are open when you ring that optimist bell. There was a capitalist in a cornfield with mud up to his knees. He had so many masters that he could never please. He thought of driving a tank right through that bank, but he knew that it wouldn't end well. So he ran straight up to the mountain for to ring that optimist bell. Let's see if you know it. Ring, 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 I'm gonna ring, 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 I'm gonna ring that optimist bell. Here's to hoping that your ears are open when you ring that optimist bell. And then I thought, why not add a donkey into the song? There was a donkey in the desert. He fell off of an old freight train. He'd seen all kinds of thirsty creatures do nothing but complain. He said, if I act like Eeyore. Well, things won't go too well. I'm gonna climb to the top of that mountain. I'm gonna ring that optimist bell. Now check this out. I wanted to add another antelope into the situation here. So this goes like this. There was an antelope eating cantaloupe in the market and looking blue. She said, I'm falling in love with a donkey, but my parents don't approve. They said an antelope can't elope, and that ain't really swell. I'm going all the way to the preacher. Here's to hoping that your ears are open and you ring that optimist. Then when I woke up, I remembered I was reading a story about the Russian space monkey named Albert, and I thought he should be in the song. There was a monkey named Albert flying up to outer space. He spoke Russian, French, and English. He had a special monkey briefcase. Well, the rocket started doing flips like a crazy carousel. And the monkey shot out of the parachute as he rang that up. Now, right here, I thought it would be so cool when I recorded to have a shredding bluegrass solo along with Dobro, but that's not possible yet. But when we do record it, it'll be great. Sunday night, if you guys are free, 9:45. But just give me a quick ceremony.
We'll be there.
All right. It's good to see you, Sean.
Man, it's so good to see you. How you been?
Good. I really look forward to this variety show. It's my favorite thing.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Let's see what we got here. Oh, yeah. You know, we normally do letters from Kayamo every year. Do you guys enjoy those? Well, I thought instead of us reading them this year, maybe we could get a long time Keanu to read a couple of the letters. What do you guys think about that idea? Can I bring the audience in? Who we got back there, guys? You got anybody? Chad, you see him around the boat.
All right.
And I think we've got a couple this
year. We do. We have two fantastic letters for you, Todd.
Okay, great.
Okay. First,
make sure you get real, you know, right on there.
Yes, sir. Okay,
don't,
first one.
Don't get your beard hung in the mic.
I know. All right. First of all, I want to say how great it is to be back on this wonderful cruise again. I believe that I am most excited that the Sean Mullins Band is not on the boat this year. It's not that they're not a great band. No, really, they are. They are. No doubt. But frankly, I don't come here to listen to the music. I come here to play the slot machines in the casino. Every night, I have my favorite spot where I love to play slots. In years past, the Sean Mullins Band has camped out every night in the casino, about 10 feet from where I love to play the slots. They're always drunk, chain-smoking, and loud. So unlike most folks, I'm glad that Sean is solo on the boat this year. Perhaps I will be able to gamble in peace. Yours truly, the Slot Machine Queen.
Not bad, not bad. All right, Slot Machine Queen, they'll be out of your hair, but I'm going to make sure that me and Steve are going to be right there for you. And all of these folks.
All right, we got
what else
one,
you got?
We got one more letter. We are first-time cruisers this year. My husband and I are massive fans of the film, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? We especially love the scene where the Soggy Bottom Boys sing Man of Constant Sorrow. Until we saw Oh Brother, we had no idea that George Clooney could sing like that. So when we found out that Clooney and the boys were going to be on the boat this year, we said, sign us up. Thank you, Kayamo. We can't wait to meet George on the boat.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dan Domesky. Put this song into words in my pajamas. My father's name was Hannibal. Mama was a Hannah Mariah. Everything we owned got all burned up. Great Depression Fire strip mines of one crop farming, drain the green earth dry. We lost it all, only love was left. That was one thing money can't buy. Just flow.
kind. Well, the only job I ever got out there was waiting in the welfare line. Once I had a dollar, once I had a dream, but now all the work, it's a being done by a big old machine.
Dig a hole in the meadow.
The liquor has ruined my body. Pretty woman, go to my head. Dig a hole, dig a hole in the meadow. Dig a hole in the cocoa ground. Dig a hole, dig a hole in the meadow. Gonna lay down and call it down. Can you hear them bluebirds singing? Can you hear that mournful sound? The preaching Corey's funeral, some lonesome graveyard ground. Dig a hole in the meadow.
Now listen, I invited someone, a friend of mine from L.A., not Los Angeles, but Lower Alabama. And I'm not sure if he's made it yet. He's got a show as well. Is Grayson back there yet? No shit? Hey, man. I was trying to look like the Big Lebowski. He's the real deal. Man, it's so good to have you, brother.
Thanks. Yeah, you're the big reason I'm here.
Well, I've known you should be on this boat for many years. I've known this guy off and on anyway for about 26 years, and he's the real deal, man. You from Mobile area, Fairhope?
In Brewton, Alabama, but I live in Fairhope now. I don't claim Mobile is weird.
We'll sing him one, boat. Grayson Katz, y'all.
This is kind of a contemplation on being the age I am. I ain't young, I ain't old. I got kids, I embrace that. But I didn't quite bargain for having parents. So I feel kind of stuck between these generations and something.
I don't take anyone's advice. I'd rather make my own way down the road. I take the gold from the sun. I hold it close when the day is done. Keep the fire inside me till the dawn. When the sun begins to rise, I'll open up with brand new eyes. Only from the dark can you see the light. And every day I'm born again, but not in any kind of Christian sense. It's only me to wash away my sins. I say, yeah, 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 you're new again.
Remember Coco Robichaud? He said I had a real young soul, many lives to live before the end. I'm getting old, my friends have died, I never got to say goodbye. But the dead, they don't miss you when they're gone. Me too, I'll up and die, but for now I'm still alive. Ain't no use for mourning what has been. I say, yeah, 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 you're new again. Yeah, 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 you're new again. There's a world of mysticism, but I'm the world of criticism for you. But no one else can get you there, but you and you, my darling, you're aware. You're aware. You're aware, yeah, yeah, you're aware. Everything's gone retrograde, waiting for the planets to align. I find myself caught between generations either side of me. The son is the father of the man. But I've been told, I've been warned, adorn thee with a crown of thorns. You will die and you'll be born again. But when it's time to say goodbye, I'll look directly in your eyes, see the holy you that lies within. I say, yeah, 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 you're new again.
Come together in music and song. So, Sing with us if you know it. It's called Winter Voice.
Left my kids at home this time. but brought the band, and Ellie's here with me as well, so I'm thrilled to be here. This is a song I wrote about my grandfather and a dream I had about him. If you don't like the song, come to a show anyways, you might get used to it. I was climbing a mountain, asleep in the moonlight. The ghost of my grandpa came to me in a dream. As the stars hung above us, he started singing this chorus. He laughed loud as heaven and said this to me: take a few chances, a few worthy romances. Go swimming in the ocean on New Year's Day. Don't listen to the critics. Stand up and bear witness. Go slay until the sunrise. A war and love and sorrow. He said, stop spending all your money on forgiveness of sins. Today is all you promised. No trouble with tomorrow. He faded into the forest, proudly singing this hymn. Take a few chances, a few.
on guitar and you guys together, if you would give us a quick instrumental song, we'll they get everything together. Thanks, man.
perform in our pajamas, so this morning, just a regular deal for us.
Actually in my room, you know, And I was already, and then, hey man, you gotta be up front. And I put my clothes on. I am so out of sync.
We didn't get the message.
Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. Well, now I'm unique. All right, hello you. I can't. You know, I was standing back there and, you know, making a joke about, I'm not going out there, there are people out there. And I heard some really fine, fast guitar play, and I said, well, all right, I'm going to slow it down. Yes, to the coin is yet to turn. Yes, to the bridges yet to burn. Yes, to the whole thing blown apart. It's open season on my heart. Days go by like flying bricks. Leave gaping holes too deep to fix. I'd just stay home if I were smart. It's open season on my heart. I can't blame anyone but me. This reckless fool I've come to be. My tired excuses just don't fit. It don't look good from where I sit. I try to change without much luck. I reach a point where I get stuck. I'd just stay home if I were smart. It's open season on my heart. It's open season on my heart. I'd just stay home if I were smart. It's open season on my heart.
Thank you,
thank you for joining us at the
at the panel. Now, you've done some real panels over your time, haven't you? Tonight Show and all that kind of stuff over the years. And... No?
Hello?
Oh, there you go.
Am I on?
You are now.
I'm on.
Really?
Well, I think with Jay Leno, I made it over to the chair and got set down.
Yeah.
And then the show was over. So, you know, they don't let musicians talk.
No, like, they don't want us to.
It's like they're afraid.
Yeah, they are. That's great.
We started out as court jesters.
You know? Oh, yeah, you know, that's right.
Like, you stay out there.
And you better be funny, too.
Yeah, you better. You better have your panel together.
That's right. Well, you don't have to have your panel together here. We're all shooting from the hip. So, you know, I love what I know of your history as a musician and those who are around you in your life. And I'm a big fan of the movie Heartworn Highways. My old buddy Larry John Wilson gave me that movie on VHS in the early 90s. And there's some wonderful footage of you and Towns and Guy and all these great songwriters, some of whom aren't with us anymore, but so glad that to have you tonight. And it's just that became my, other than these Roseanne Cash records that I was just blown away by also. Do you have any Johnny Cash stories or anything for us? Because he knows the guy. He knew the guy.
Right, yeah. Well,
is there anything you could tell us?
Well, yeah, we talked about this, so let's be straight up.
Damn.
It's not really, but it's, you know, I owe it.
It's cold, Rodney. I'm doing the best I can. You're supposed to act like we didn't.
I just realized I won't be invited back.
Yes, you will.
No, I'm happy to tell that story. I call it my greatest hit. And Sean's alluding to when I, before I was married to Roseanne Cash for 13 years. You know, she and I think she says this, but I always say that it was a successful marriage. You know, it just ended so that I could be married to the woman I'm married to now, which is really works. But as it was, you know, John and June, you know, had a certain, there were rules, you know, that, I mean, they weren't, well, the rules were that you don't live together in sin. And Roseanne and I were living together in sin in L.A. And we got a summons to Jamaica where John and June had a sugar plantation in Montego Bay. So, you know, the first class tickets came in the mail, you know, and I said, okay, here we go. We're going to square off, you know.
Yeah. You know, had you met him yet?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I met him. You know, but I always wanted to be my own man, you know. I was like, oh, well, just, you know, I'm my own man. You're the man in black, but, you know, I got my own thing, you know. I'm not gold digging, and I'm somebody, you know. So L.A. to Miami, I started with Bloody Marys, and I whacked on it. You know, I was going fast, you know, because I knew there was going to be a showdown of some sort. I wasn't sure what it was going to be. And then in Miami, I'd never been to Jamaica. I'd never been anywhere then, and it's like, ah, well, you know, I'm going to switch to a rum punch from Miami to Montego Bay, you know, and so, you know, by the time I got to Jamaica, I was somebody else. I was that guy I wanted to be. So, you know, this house, it was built in 1750 by the Barretts of Whipple Street, Elizabeth Barrett Browning's family. It's very beautiful shutters, and it's a sugar plantation. So I was wandering upstairs where I'd been assigned a room, and I was walking past this one room, and I heard Roseanne in there talking to her dad, and tears were going, you know, and there was, I kind of picked up, so the discussion was about us sleeping together under his roof. So I was still in the throes of my new self. So I screwed it up, you know, and I walked in here and said, yeah, well, you know, I would be a hypocrite if I didn't live my life in the same way here that I do in L.A., you know, it's like, so, you know, I'm just letting you know who I am about this. And John says, son, I don't know you well enough to miss you if you were to leave. Man, I sobered up. Turned on a dime and said, yes, sir, you are absolutely correct. I have a little daughter, and, you know, someday I'm going to use that line myself. Thank you very much. Go down the hall, and I'll see you for breakfast.
That's a wonderful story.
Thank you. Thank you, Abby.
I can't believe I got to hear that.
You're welcome to hang.
Man, that was good.
I'm not properly impressed.
Y'all, welcome the Quakey Sisters. Where are you from?
Well, we are from Dallas, Texas.
Okay.
Any Texans in the audience? Well, we've got a tune for y'all. This is off of our brand new album, and it's a little country shuffle that I wrote. And I hope you like some country shuffles. We do, because, you know, we're from Texas. So are we all plugged in and ready to roll? I think so. Well, here you go. This is called My Love, My Life, My Friend. Walking down the crowded city street, the morning rush was pressing me, my world was caving in, but now I have you by my side, my love, my life, my friend. Let's drown in every ocean, blow in every wind, we'll love the stars out of the sky.
Let's do a little sing-along to end this thing. Y'all been so good to us. And I know it was different. It was a brunch this year, but I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll be